So far, we've covered the administrative areas of content, structure, appearance, and extend. Now, let's look at the configuration section. Click on Configuration with me. Remember, only site administrators get access to this area. And because you're the super user, user number one, of course you have access to everything. This particular area allows you to change the behavior and configure the functionality of different aspects of your site. As it shows, basic site information, account settings, text formats and editors, performance optimizations, maintenance mode, image styles, and others. We'll be exploring several of these as we go through this course. But for now, let's just update some basic site information. Under the System category, click on Basic Site Information. And let's make a slight change to our site name. I'll change it from Waterfall Handbook to The Waterfall Handbook. One of the great things with a content management system, as I mentioned earlier, is that when we make changes like this, they change the entire site. So whether you have one page or 5,000 pages on your site, the site name across the top of every single page will be what is configured here. Certainly, that is ever an improvement over static HTML. Here, we can also provide a slogan. Note that whether the slogan can or will actually be displayed is dependent upon the active theme and other configurations set in the site branding block. At the time of this recording, the active theme Olivero does not render the site slogan. For comparison, the Bartik theme does render the slogan. The email address is the from address in automated email sent, as it says. You may remember filling in much of this information during the install phase of Drupal. You have the ability to point the front page of Drupal to a specific page. The default is /node, which displays a list of teasers of the content on your site. For demonstration purposes, let's change the default page to be the article we created earlier. So follow along, and in a new tab, open the home front page. You should see the Who Doesn't Like a Good Waterfall article listed somewhere, and open that in an additional new tab. The reason that we did this is so we can get the relative URL of the article. For me, it is /node/1. I'll copy this and go back over to the Basic Site Settings tab to paste the relative URL into the default front page text area. You can set custom error pages if you wish. For us, let's click Save Configuration with the modified site name and modified default front page. Now, in the second tab we opened, which should be displaying the old default front page, click on the refresh button in your browser. If you happen to have closed the tab to the front page, just open it again. After you have refreshed or opened the front page, you'll see that it now defaults to the good waterfall article we had created earlier. To see how it really works, I'm going to go to a different page, such as the content admin area. Then click on the home link, and sure enough, it takes me straight to the Who Doesn't Like a Good Waterfall article. Now, at this point, I happen to like the home front page to be the default teaser listing more than I like the home to be this article. So let's change the default front page back to how it was. We'll learn how to create custom home page using Layout Builder later on in this course. To change the default front page again, using Admin Toolbar, go back and hover over Configuration in the Admin menu. Then hover over System, then click on Basic Site Settings. In the default front page text box, delete everything and re-enter /node as it was before. Save Configuration, then click the home link to go back to the front page. Awesome! We have our list of teasers like before. So this concludes this video. Congratulations on understanding an overview of the configuration area used to change the available behavior of your site. Catch you in the next video. Happy learning!